for last week's show, Daniel Grosset from Clay Nation and all the Clay Nation from down there in Croydon. Hello, howdy, howdy, howdy. If you missed that show, you can listen to that via the podcast. Very simple. Just go on to CroydonRadio.com, the website, click podcast and my name, the game video show, and you can listen to that again. It's very simple. You can also download it as well. All sorts of other stuff. Yes. We've got a fun packed show today, full of goodies, full of great music as per usual. So yes, thank you very much for tuning in. We're going to go into some great music now. This one is from a personal crazy favorite. I played the a cappella version of this song. Well, actually, it was like the sort of a piano version of this song a few weeks ago. It's by the great man Takenobu Mitsuyoshi, and this one is from, you know what, I'm not even going to tell you the name of this song. I'm just going to let you go nuts to this. If you were around in the arcades twenty years ago, is that even right? 15, 16, 17 years ago, yeah. Wow, yeah, it's about 20 years now. Almost, yeah. Anyway, if you was around that time, especially in Trocadero in London, or anywhere else around the world for that fact, anywhere, you know, which had an arcade, you know, sort of set up, then you would have played this game at some point. It's probably the greatest racing game of all time. You know, the four-player boxes, the VR, changing your screens. I think you kind of get the message now. It was developed by Sega. Yes, anyway, let's play it now. You're going to laugh. This song just makes me giggle all the time. He's a great guy, Mitsuyoshi Takenobu. But just the lyrics are so funny. You're burning out your tires, baby.
Where? all that. Oh man, this song is just so classic. It's like the soundtrack of the arcades. It just took over every single game that was ever playing in the arcades, didn't it? Just like the loudest speaker. Street Fighter 2 just didn't stand a chance when this was playing.
Listen to that! Wow, he just like blew away everybody there. Like literally, that has got to be one of the most overblown video game tracks of all time. If you can like tell me anything that is more like, you know, spectacular than that, then please, you just let me know. That is just awesome. Don't forget, you can tweet us at Game Video Show 1. I need to change the Twitter. And yes, Dan, you'll remember that as well. I've tried to change it online. It didn't work. So for now, everybody, you can follow it at Game Video Show number 1. Okay, follow it. That's all one word. Easy peasy. And also we're on Facebook as well, which is Game Video Show on Facebook. Very simple, very simple. And Croydon Radio is very simple as well, at Croydon Radio on Twitter. That's where you get all the updates. And every single tune that we play is comes out as an individual tweet. So you can retweet and tweet and tweet back and forth to everybody else. So it's pretty good. Yes, yes, yes. Oh gosh. This week I've, you know, been keeping it very old school with the gaming now. I've been playing a lot of Sega Dreamcast this week. I've been playing a lot of Daytona actually, hence the reason I played it. And you know, played this song. So I've been playing that. And I played a bit of Revolt. Have you played that game before on Sega Dreamcast? It's like a sort of toy racing game. My daughters have been playing it too, and they've been enjoying it. It's a bit noisy, though, that game, though, and the repetitive sound effects can sometimes get into your brain as well. But other than that, it's a very good game, actually. You know, it reminds me of Micro Machines. Who remembers Micro Machines? That was a pretty brilliant game. I need to find a copy of that somewhere. I had that on PlayStation 2 at one point, and that was just like the most addictive game ever. Micro Machines, just racing around the kitchen and jumping over like plates of cereal and stuff like that and trying not to drop into the milk. That was pretty crazy. Loved that game. Anyway, so it's been very retro this week. I think I only played Splatoon like once, which is like a record, even though they had a new update recently as well, which is quite strange because I'm always playing Splatoon, which was very weird. But, you know, this time round, it didn't happen. There wasn't any Splatoon. So yes. Anyway, no problems. We'll keep it moving now with the music. And going into this one now, this is from a Czech Republic composer by the name of Tomáš Dvořák. Yes, I guess I may have said that right, I hope. And this one is from a brilliant, brilliant point-and-click game released on the PC a few years ago now, called Machinarium. Have you ever played this game before? It's wonderful, really good. It's about this little robot that you sort of he makes himself up from the junk. He's been thrown in the junk, and he has to find out the reason why, you know, he's been thrown in the junk, and go back into the machine city to find out, you know, the reasons why things are happening, etc. But I'm not going to reveal too much of it, but it's such a brilliant game. Really good, really inventive. And, you know, the environment is full of this, like, dystopian, you know, full of recycled metal everywhere, junk metal, and these robots that run the thing. And it's very comical and full of humor as well. So I suggest you can play it whenever you can. It's really, really good. Very impressive game. This one is called The Sea from Machinarium, and it's by Tomáš Dvořák. It's very wonderful. Enjoy this one. Dvorak, The Sea from the Machinarium original soundtrack. Quite awesome. Love that. Such a beautiful game as well. You know, I still play it to this day, actually. I haven't actually completed the game. I usually give up when it gets a bit too hard. I'm a bit of a lame gamer. Hence the reason I play music, but no. Very good game, and I need to pick that up again and have a go. You can also download it now as well on iOS and Android now as well, so you can play it on your tablet. It's pretty cool. Really good game. Very good. Definitely pick it up when you can. It's a lot more fun than playing Super Jewel Quest. Shout out to, I can't remember your name now. Is it Dimitri? Dimitri from Play Nation, talking about Super Jewel Quest on his fantastic Samsung. That is an amazing, amazing game, seriously. If you haven't played Super Jewel Quest on that really annoying Samsung phone, which you can buy anywhere for about £5, please do pick it up immediately and play it. And, you know, maybe I might even play the music from that fantastic intro, which is basically an Indiana Jones ripoff. So well done, Samsung. Keep up the good work. Awesome. You're listening to the Game Video Show with myself, Ivian Caffin, live here on CroydonRadio.com. What have you been playing this week? What games have you been playing? Have you been keeping it retro, or is it all modern? Are you playing like Uncharted 4 at the moment, or are you playing, you know, Hang On? Are you playing Hang On? You know, are you one of those purists that just can't get into the future? You know, you just, no, I refuse to play anything, you know, with rendered backgrounds. There are people like that out there, you know. You know, I'm not totally weird. Seriously, I'm not the only one. Believe me, believe me, believe me. Tell me about it. Anyway, talking about, you know, pretty old and out there and fantastic as well. We're going to get into a series of tracks now from literally, you know, a brilliant RPG. Goes by the name of Mother, or Mother 3. This game hasn't officially been released here in any of the Western regions, so should we say USA and UK and other regions, etc., power regions. USA, UK. USA is sort of NTSC, isn't it? Yeah, anyway, let's not get too technical. It hasn't been released in the USA and the UK officially. There isn't an actual English translation for this game. It's Japan only. But Mother 3 is a wonderful and you know, touching and moving and humorous game from Nintendo, which originally came out on the Nintendo DS, I believe. Was it the Nintendo DS or even before that, wasn't it? Gosh. It's a wonderful piece of work. And the soundtrack, I just love. It's very quirky, very funny as well. And it's just got some, you know, nice little gems on there that just like get to you. And they're just great. Literally, it's composed in its entirety by Sakai Shogo, and it's just brilliant. I'm going to get into a double whammy now of good music from the Mother 3 soundtrack live on Croydon Radio with myself, Ivian Caffin. I hope you're enjoying the show, and stay locked. Don't forget, we're here till 6 p.m. with video game music goodness and some exclusive news coming up soon about a possible, well, it's not possible, it's a live event that we're going to do as well. So I'll give you more details about that as well. Listen to this one. Is anyone there? We'll be right back.
From the heart of Old Town. Community radio for the London Borough of Croydon.
Using basic radio principles.
This is Croydon Radio.
Was called And Then There Were None. It's quite dystopian there, isn't it? Quite downbeat, but wonderful game and wonderful soundtrack. Really, really cool. I love like every song from that soundtrack. I can just listen to it all night long, which I have before as well. So yes. It's the Game Video Show with myself, Ibian Caff. If this is your first time tuning in, then welcome to an amazing show where we play nothing but video game music. So this could be from any era, any platform. We don't discriminate. We don't just play Nintendo music or Sega music. We play every music. And I'm going to prove that point right about now with something from the PS4. Yes, can you believe I'm going this modern? You know, this is probably the most modern. This game is probably only a few weeks old. This is how new this song is. It's fresh out of the box. Fresh. I haven't actually played this game yet, but I did like the soundtrack when I heard it on a recent trailer from one of those famous YouTube gamers, and it was nice, and I liked it, so I seeked it out, and now here it is. It's wonderful. It's from the fantastic action-adventure game by the name of Uncharted 4. It's out right now on the Sony PlayStation 4. That's good, isn't it? Uncharted 4 and the PlayStation 4. Did they do that intentionally? I wonder. Good marketing, Sony, and good marketing, Naughty Dog, who developed this game as well. So wonderful, wonderful. The game looks glorious. It really does. And I probably won't get to play it right now because I just can't afford a PS4 at this present time. So if you would like to donate, please do at Game Video Show 1, or you can send it to me using your address details on the Facebook page, which is Game Video Show. Please donate. I might even start a Kickstarter to get me a PS4. You know why? Because it will allow me to play more great music, which I can discover. So yeah, so do that. It makes a lot of sense, really. Start a Kickstarter just like Shenmue. I might even get like $6 million or something like that. We'll see how it goes. Yes, yes. This one is composed by Henry Jackman. I've heard his name a few times bounced around in certain video games here and there, and also in the film world as well. So this does sound very film-like, but then again, most video game, you know, soundtracks are going that way now, with the orchestral sounds and the big cellos and violins and trumpets and trombones everywhere. But this one is very glorious and very out there. It's the main theme from Uncharted 4. Awesome. That's wonderful. And that's Henry Jackman, the main theme from Uncharted 4. Out now on Sony PS4. Buy it now at your local retailer, including PlayNation Games in Croydon. Only $39.99, I think. That was my lame attempt at an advertisement there. I just read about Henry Jackman here. I read that he was classically trained, which you can hear, and he also attended St. Paul's Cathedral Choir School, Eton College, and Oxford University. Isn't that like some, like, you know, ultra-gifted person that goes to these establishments? You know, you can just imagine, you know, why the music sounds so great. And he's, you know... Gosh, blew me away with that one. That's really good. I really need to play the game. So when I heard that, I thought, oh, this game is serious. It's going to have some some good stuff in it. And I've been reading the reviews, and you know, you have to be a bit careful with the reviews that you read, because some of them are paid. You know, Naughty Dog might pay somebody, you know, to write a good review. Naughty Dog, naughty, naughty. But, you know, from what I can see from YouTubers and real fans that haven't been paid, it sounds and looks great. So I need to get onto that one and play Uncharted 4. Looks fantastic. Looks very good, very good. And that's a great piece of work there from Henry Jackman. I'm going to listen out for more music from him as well. Yeah, very good, very good, very good. Okay, now back into my weekly ritual. That's a bit much, but weekly ritual of playing music from, you know, a game that I play all of the time, every time, every other day, every minute. It's from the composers, the glorious Minegishi Toru and Shiho Fuji, or Toru Minegishi and Shiho Fuji. You may know these names. They're like a who's who of Nintendo. They've played literally on every Nintendo soundtrack, all the main franchises like Legend of Zelda, Super Mario, pretty much everything, really. Kirby, Super Smash Brothers. But you know, this one, they handled this soundtrack by themselves. It's the Splatoon soundtrack, also known as Splatoon, and this one is from the single player campaign. Yes, Octopus Valley, or Octo Valley as it's called on there, and it's Cefalo Parade. Yes, I like this one. It's a bit of a mouthful, and Cefalo Parade. I like these the names that they have on this soundtrack. They're very creative, like Inca Jamaica is one of them, the dub track. When you're waiting in the lobby, that one's my favorite. And there's so many others. Cracking Up, and what's the other tracks called? Cracking Up, and yeah. Anyway, it's fantastic. And I don't know if you caught the recent performance of the Squid Sisters, if you're familiar with the game. The Squid Sisters are a bunch of sisters, obviously, who do all the music in the game. They do all the singing, and they join you in the single-player campaign and talk you through the battle against the great DJ Octavio, who sits in his massive DJ booth and tries to blow you into oblivion, which, you know, it's a funny, really cool boss battle, which frustrated me at times, but I did complete it in the end. I like the single player campaign of Splatoon. I wish it was a bit longer, and I think they'll remedy that on the next one, and maybe even turn it into a two-player campaign. Let's see what they do for the next Splatoon, which is going to be absolutely amazing, I can imagine, and will also appear on a Nintendo NX in about 3 years time, I guess, after all the updates are being exhausted. But this one here is amazing. It's called Cefalo Parade, live here on The Game Video Show with myself, Ivian Caffin. Enjoy this one. Yosh. We'll be right back. Fallow Parade, composed by Toro Minegishi and Shiho Fuji. And that's from the Splatoon original soundtrack, out now on Nintendo Wii U. You can get that for a bargain right now. Go and buy it. Seriously, I love the Nintendo Wii U. I love Splatoon. Nintendo Wii U, it's great. It's great. I couldn't care less what you think. It's amazing. It's the whole reason I don't have a PS4, and some people might think I'm completely crazy, but it has kept me occupied along with the Sega Dreamcast. And I am yet to play the PS4, but there is a game, or there are two games actually, that are just, you know, I now want a PS4 now, which is The Last Guardian, a new game, which just looks amazing. It looks and it plays amazing as well. I can't wait to play it. It's developed by the team Ico, the same developers of the game Ico and Shadow of the Colossus, which was just a blinding game. Seriously, both of those games were amazing. The Last Guardian, you're basically, I don't know much details about the game, but I can see that you're like a young child. And you look after this huge beast, similar to Shadow of the Colossus. And, I don't know many details about it. So, you know, what I would do is if, you know, go onto that favorite video sharing website and just have a look and type in The Last Guardian, you'll be able to check out the trailer. It's mind-blowing, seriously. The other game that I'm looking forward to playing on the PS4 as well is Shenmue 3. Yes. Time to start the saga again, and I just can't wait to play that. That will be out at the tail end of 2017, December 2017, developed by the great man himself, Yu Suzuki. I can't wait to play that. So I think those are the two things that I'd like to get the PS4 for eventually. But yeah, I'm not rushing to buy one at the moment. Can you actually do backwards compatibility on the PS4? That will be interesting to know. I need to Google that or ask somebody. Or if you know, then tweet me at Ivian Caffin or at Game Video Show 1 or Game Video Show on Facebook. Can you play PS3, PS2 games or even PS1 games on the PS4? I don't think you can. I know I read about some sort of update for the Xbox One, but I don't know. I'm not sure. So please let me know, because that could be a game clincher for me. Yes, because it always is. I mean, it's quite a shame when you can't play your large collection of games that you had from your PS2 or even your PS3, etc., and play them on the next generation console. I mean, that's quite disappointing. So let's hope there is some sort of a software update to enable that to happen. Come on, Sony, you have billions, literally. Sort it out. If you haven't already done it. Otherwise, I'll eat my glasses. Yeah, anyway, into some Sega Dreamcast goodies now. This one is from Rokudo Haruyoshi, and this one is from Elemental Gimmick Gear, also known as EGG or Egg. Yes, a game called Egg. There was a game called Egg, and it was great. It almost played like a mechanical sort of Legend of Zelda. It was that top-down look on the Sega Dreamcast, and the soundtrack was really nice as well. It was probably the closest thing that, I don't know, Sega had to Legend of Zelda, to me anyway. Maybe if you can tell me something else, that kind of matches Legend of Zelda in terms of gameplay and the feel. But Elemental Gimmick Gear was amazing, brilliant game, really fun to play. You wake up in this sort of pod, which is called an egg, basically, and you've been there for hundreds of years, supposedly, and you now wake up and you can't remember your name, you don't remember anything, and the whole city's changed around you, and you need to find out why you're here and what's going on, and that's where the adventure starts. And I love the music in this game from Rokudo Haruyoshi. And it's really good. This one's called Isto Kion, and it's one of the first tracks from the soundtrack itself. And please have a listen. You're listening to the Game Video Show live here on Croydon Radio with myself, Ivian Caffin. That sounded very grandiose, didn't it? Let's do it again. Ivian Caffin. Thank you. I still play it to this day. It is brilliant. The only part I don't like is the 3D battle scenes in it. It's a bit corny, actually. If you play the game, I think you know what I mean. It just turns into this whole, like, Street Fighter fest. Like, there's just no need for it. You know, they could have kept it, like, you know, the same view, but they decided to go, hey, let's just do 3D rendering for this and, you know, just show the capabilities of the Dreamcast. Yeah, let's just do it. Let's just fling this 3D scene in here. Yeah, I don't understand when some... Yeah, I think it was just during the time of, you know, that time around 1998, 1999, where cutscenes were everywhere. You know, you used to watch, play Tomb Raider, and there'll be a cutscene every 10 seconds. Metal Gear Solid, cutscene. But then again, Metal Gear Solid used some of the rendered, the actual gameplay for their cutscenes, which was pretty good. But before that, you know, you'd have the game looking like, you know, pretty much like, you know, 16-bit, and then it would just morph itself up to this 32-bit crazy cutscene with 3D rendered backgrounds, and it's like the whole budget went on the cutscene. And this kind of reminded me of Elemental Gimmick Gear, that part of when you're playing, you know, the 3D fighting scene, it just turns into this 3D fest of just madness, and it was just insane. I didn't understand why they put it in there. That's the only letdown in the game. Other than that, the game is solid. It's very good, and if you get a chance to pick it up on the Sega Dreamcast, then please do. It is awesome. We like it. We love it here at the Game Video Show. It's fantastic. Do you have that there at PlayNation Games? I wonder if they have that. I'm not sure. We'll have to have a look next time we pop in down in Croydon. Don't forget to visit them down in Croydon, PlayNation Games. A wonderful place full of goodies, full of crazy stuff in there, and crazy staff as well. Yes, probably the most insane bunch I've ever met on the planet. They are nuts. Each one of them should have their own YouTube show, channel, etc., and submit it to BBC Three for possible airing around 2 a.m. in the morning. Yes, they are that nuts there. It's not like I can talk much for myself, you know. It's not like I'm pretty normal as well. But anyway, down at PlayNation Games in Croydon, they also do weekly tournaments, including the Super Smash Brothers tournament every Thursday. I think it's from about 6 or 7. Correct me if I'm wrong. But come down and test your skills against some of Croydon's finest gamers as well, which is pretty good. So we'll see how that goes. I'll go down there and get absolutely massacred playing as Pac-Man. We'll see how it goes. But, you know, maybe I can pull it off if I just button bash my way to glory, as I always do. We'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes. I don't even actually know how to pull off a proper special on Super Smash Brothers. I just press all the buttons together, all the back buttons, LR and ZR, or whatever they're called on the Wii U gamepad, and it just works somehow, some way, somewhere. Anyway, fun times playing games. Yes, courtesy of me. Anyway, into some more music now. We're going to go into this one. I've played his music a few times over the last couple of weeks. He goes by the name of Tomohito Nishiura. He's from Fukuoka in the southwest of Japan, a wonderful city which I've actually had the pleasure to visit about a year and a half ago now. Great place, lovely city, and they make some good music. And also one of my friends there as well, Ken Inaoka, who I played one of his songs recently over the last couple of weeks. If you missed it, then you can go back to a few podcasts ago and you'll find that song. It's wonderful. And so, yes, this tune is called The Underground Ruins. It's from the soundtrack of Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. I like to just exaggerate these names. It doesn't even say that, but I still haven't worked, you know, listened to the Ace Attorney voice yet, which I've been wanting to mimic. I don't even know his voice. He probably doesn't have a voice. Does he have a voice? It's probably just like Nintendo puts some text there and it's press A. Press A again. That's usually how it works, isn't it? Anyway, but let's get into this one. This one is quite glorious as well. Tomohito Nishiura is very impressive. His music is brilliant. I really like his part of the soundtrack as well. I do like the Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, and it does suit the character, but this Professor Layton music from Nishiura-san is very impressive. Very good. Yes. Oh, don't forget, it's also, you can check us out on the social media channels. It's Game Video Show on Facebook and also at Game Video Show number one. Not number one, but the number one. Game Video Show one. I need to change it, I know. On Twitter as well. I couldn't get the game video show by itself because somebody has it and they haven't used their Twitter since 2010, unfortunately. So they should maybe give that to me. If you're listening, then please hand it over at once or I shall get my Monado from Xenoblade Chronicles on you. That's a bit violent, isn't it? I'm sorry. I apologize. Sounds there of Tomohito Nishiura, the Underground Ruins, and that's from Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. You can play that on the Nintendo 3DS, and it looks good. And if you're into those sort of mystery games, which I am as well, I need to get myself a Nintendo 3DS as well, but I'm definitely going to have to get one for my girls as well. Eventually, because it's great. It's really good for long plane flights as well, isn't it? You know, playing at Nintendo 3DS. Much better than watching the lamest film behind someone's head on a plane in cattle class or economy. Yeah, need to get a Nintendo 3DS. Hopefully we can find a charger for it and charge it in the back of that person's head on the back of their seat. That would be really good. Yes, I like that. Very nice there from Tomohito Nishiura. Very nice. Me likey very much. You're listening to the game video show. It's 4:53 at the moment. We are here till 6 p.m. or 1800 hours. And it's currently 18 Celsius here in Croydon. It's a nice day. It's very pleasant. It's been very changeable weather over the last couple of days, but it seems to have settled down for now. I haven't got my umbrella for me, so I'm saying that to reassure myself just in case I step outside and there is sleet. You know, we never know here in Croydon. It just changes, you know, but you get used to it. You get used to it. The rain was really nice yesterday. It just pounded down the pavement and cleaned all of the sins away from Croydon High Street. It did a good job. So well done. Keep up the good work, weather. Anyway, let's get into some more music now. Today, we've got plenty to go and so much nostalgia here as well. And I'm going to play some literal nostalgia now. This one is just, man, man. This came into my head recently because I've been playing Shenmue, as I always do, and Shenmue 2. You know, I'm a bit obsessive. And, you know, when you go into the arcades with your character, Ryo Hazuki, into the local arcade in Shenmue 1, you can play this game. So you can play a game within a game. Yes, Yu Suzuki did this long before Grand Theft Auto, you know, did this. And, you know, this is why we salute this guy. But you can actually play one of Yu Suzuki's games in Yu Suzuki's games, if you get what I mean. So in Shenmue, you can use your character, go into the local arcade and play Hang On! No, I'm not saying Hang On. The game's called Hang On! It's actually called Hang On, okay? Actually hurt my throat. But yeah, Hang On, great. Literally one of the first racing games I ever played, along with Outrun. Man, and it was just brilliant. I was never good at it. I could probably only get past the first, like, sort of lap or up to the first checkpoint, and then after that it just got too tough. You always end up flying off the grass. And even now, I can't play it that well. I always end up hitting a sign and my driver just goes rolling, and it's a tough game. So literally, I can imagine people burning loads of coins in the arcade playing that. And I remember as well that you could actually get onto the actual motorcycle itself and try to turn it left and right. And, you know, I wasn't very good at that either, but it was so much fun to play, and it's really, really cool. And we're going to play the original, the main theme. And this one's composed by Hiroshi Kawaguchi and Mr. Ishii. I like that name, Mr. Ishii. Someone called themselves Mr. Ishii, not Ishii-sama, but Mr. Ishii. That's very cool. This one is Hang On. I'm not saying Hang On. This one is the main theme from Hang On, the Sega classic, developed by Yu Suzuki. Amazing. Listen to it in all of its, 8-bit glory. just one of the best like songs ever in a video game. I've said that about lots of tracks, but that really is. That's just brilliant. I love it. Love that snare as well. That I'm not much of a beatboxer, but anyway, that was really cool. Hiroshi Kawaguchi and Mr. Ishii, and that's the main theme from Hang On. Yeah, wonderful. Produced by AM2, Yu Suzuki's company. Well, that company has now changed into something else. I'm not sure what his company's called now. Also released on the Sega. Which Sega was that on? God damn, I've totally forgotten. I don't want to embarrass myself. It wasn't the Master System, was it? No. It had to be the Mega Drive or the Genesis, as they call it abroad. But anyway, amazing, amazing, amazing. I love that game. I'm going to try and play it while I'm playing Shenmue and see if I can get any further than I could last time, because I'm still not good at that game, and I need to feel like a man to master a racing game, you know? You have to play a racing game at some point if you're a man, because that's what makes you a man, by playing a racing game. Yeah. Yeah, it's true, seriously. If you don't drive, then, you know, play a racing game and feel like a man. Preferably something like Hang On, Outrun, or Daytona. Daytona will give you hairs on your chest if you play that long enough, literally, seriously. Play Daytona USA in an arcade, preferably. And if you can't find that, then play at home on the Sega Saturn or Sega Dreamcast, and it will literally, you know, supercharge you. Definitely. I recommend it anytime soon. Okay, it's the Game Video Show. We've just gone past 5 o'clock and there is so much to play. I'm going to go into this one. It's a wonderful platformer that I love dearly, and the soundtrack is just happy. And it's produced by a company called Good Feel. So, yeah, that's probably why Nintendo, told these guys to make this game, because it's really good. Good Feel. It gives you good feels, definitely. It's Yoshi's Woolly World. I played something at the start of the show called Bounce About Woods. This one is called The Desert Pyramid Beckons, and it's by Tomita. Oh, let me get the name. I'm going to get it in a second. I'll tell you after I play it. That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? But anyway, it's called The Desert Pyramid Beckons, and I've just forgotten the composers because it's just like left my head. I usually have everything in this brain, but it's gone. It's gone, never to be found again. Gone, I tell you, gone on the Game Video Show. Listen.
Very nice. I like that very much. That's the Desert Pyramid Beckons, and that's composed by Tomoya Tomita and Misaki Asada. And that's from the Yoshi's Woolly World original soundtrack, out now on the Nintendo Wii U. Wonderful game. Really good. Lots and lots of fun to play and very challenging as well. You should pick it up and have a go. It's really, really good. Really nice looking as well. It's actually Yoshi actually looks like yarn, you know, woolly yarn, hence the name Yoshi's Woolly World. It was actually called Yoshi's Yarn, I think, before they came up with the name Yoshi's Woolly World, which is a lot better, isn't it, Yoshi's Yarn? It just sounds like some sort of, you're going to be playing with a yarn ball for about 11 hours, I guess, but that's what cats do. So yeah, anyway, don't knock the hustle. Game Video Show, more music to come. And don't forget, we're on social media. It's very simple. It's at Ivian Caffin or at Game Video Show 1. Also on Facebook, it's Game Video Show. And at Croydon Radio, if you want to get the latest of our tweets and what we're playing now. No, definitely. What will you be playing this week? I'm going to attempt to play more. Let me see. I actually played Vampire Chronicle yesterday, Darkstalkers. Wow, yes, what a game. It's quite gory as well. I didn't realize. I played with Morrigan. All the way up to the end, and I just couldn't beat that boss. I can't remember his name, but he's quite a gruesome fellow. And that stage, what was it? The Fetus of God? The last stage, that was just insane, that stage design. I'd like to see an updated version of that, but I know it's not going to happen with Capcom and the way they're acting at the moment. They can't even push out a new Mega Man at the moment, which is quite a shame, you know, hence the original creator of Mega Man had to go and create his own Mega Man, literally, Mighty Number 9, which is currently slated to be released this month at some point as well. So we'll see how that goes. But yes, Capcom, pull up your socks, please. Come on, Darkstalkers, Rival Schools, come on, there's so much to play. Power Stone 1 and 2, come on. Even a HD remaster would just be brilliant and let some people that haven't played these gems, let them play it, because it will be really cool. You know, we don't just want to be known just for Street Fighter. Even though Street Fighter is an amazing game and it's brilliant, etc., etc. I mean, there's such good games that they have out there and they need to push them, really. So, you know, but I do understand this era of business and money making, because it is a business after all. You seem to forget that sometimes when you play these games. You think, you know, why don't they just do this? And why don't they just make, you know, Hang On HD remastered, re-rendered version, or Outrun HD for the PS4. I mean, that would be pretty pointless. We'd just play like everything else. But, you know, it's a business at the end of the day, and that's how it is. I hate to break it to you, but we're in the corporate world. But on this show in particular, we don't care about that. We just play great music. And talking of going against the grain here, I'm going to play something now from an extraordinary fellow. His name is Toby Fox. He goes by the name of Toby Fox. That is his name. It's literally a wonderful story here. Toby created this game. It's called Undertale. Himself, basically. Obviously, he had some help from some fellows. But the game itself plays like a dream, actually. It's out now on Steam. You can buy it on the Steam store online. And it's really good, really, really good. From what I've seen, I haven't actually played through the game yet, but I'm looking forward to spending a lot of time playing it. Looks wonderful. And one thing I do really enjoy about this game, from looking at Let's Plays, etc., is the music. And he also composed the music as well, which is even more, like, glorious to me, because I'm really into music, as you can see or hear. And the soundtrack is just brilliant, brilliant. Had the chance to speak to Toby actually via email in regards to, you know, his music, etc. as well. And he's really happy, you know, to allow us to play the music online as well, which is really good. So thank you very much, sir, if you are listening. And let's get into this one. This is from Undertale, the original soundtrack, which you can purchase with the game as well on Steam as well. And you can support this independent artist who is from the United Kingdom as well. which is even more brilliant. So great. Have a listen to this one. It's really nice. This is Undertale from the Undertale original soundtrack. Yeah. I very much like it. That's Toby Fox from the Undertale original soundtrack. Absolutely glorious. Very nice. And salutes to you, sir. independent video game developer and composer, did practically the whole thing himself. Well, that is serious discipline and dedication. Really amazing. Also UK, from the United Kingdom as well. UK born and bred, I guess. I'm not sure, but absolutely brilliant. Really good. You can pick up this game on Steam, on the Steam website, and you can also pick up the soundtrack and the game for free. I think it's about £13, £13.99, which is an absolute bargain. You get a quality soundtrack and the game as well, which is totally indie independent as well. It's like a mix of, it reminds me a lot of Mother 3, Earthbound, etc. Has touches of Legend of Zelda as well, but basically, it's one of the games where you can go through the whole game without actually killing anyone or hurting anyone. Usually, most video games, there's an element of beating someone up or beating a monster or beating a boss, but you don't actually have to do that. You can be a pacifist for the whole game, which I think is very neat and very smart. So, yes, pick that up now. It's Undertale. It's out on Steam. Wonderful. Very nice. It's the Game Video Show. It's 16 minutes past 5 and we're live here on CroydonRadio.com. So much music to come. Yes. There's so much to go. Let's go into something lovely as well. Equally as lovely, equally as brilliant as well. This one comes from, yes, you'll like it. Let's pop it over here. That makes sense, doesn't it? This one is from the very well-known Square Enix Disney collaboration. Goes by the name of Kingdom Hearts. And this one's from Kingdom Hearts 2, the RPG. Wonderful game, which I've actually only played once, actually, before. But the soundtrack is composed by one of my favorite composers. Goes by the name of Yoko Shimomura. And this one's called Dearly Beloved from Kingdom Hearts 2. It's glorious. It's very nice. And it does give you the feels here on Game Video Show. Yoko Shimomura, Dearly Beloved, from the Kingdom Hearts original soundtrack. And she is a giant in the video game composition department. Compose everything from Street Fighter 2 to Kingdom Hearts, to Final Fantasy, to Xenoblade, pretty much everything. All of those cool RPGs and a fighting game, obviously. Ah, brilliant. Fantastic. So much good work from Yoko Shimomura. And you can check it out on YouTube and other outlets as well for her live performances with a full orchestra. They're amazing. They'll blow you away, literally, with the sound. Hello to DJ Steve. Howdy, howdy. Thank you for tuning in to the Game Video Show. Merci, merci. Hope all is well. And hello to everyone else from the CroydonRadio.com stable. Keep up the good work. Don't forget, there's so much different types of music to listen to, including DJ Steve's show and just brilliant music. There's everything from country to metal to rock to, genres and me don't get on. But anyway, hip-hop to R&B to grime to everything, pop, whatever you like, it's there. And we also have some great talk shows and documentary-type shows as well. So please tune in and keep it locked, Croydon Radio, or at least bookmark us as well, which is always a good thing. So you can find us very easy and very simple. And pay us a visit as well. We're only in Croydon, St. Matthew's Yard here, just down the little side street of Surrey Street Market here, Old Town in Croydon. It's pretty fantastic. I was out here the other day watching the cyclists here in Croydon for the Pearl Izumi races around Croydon, which was really fun, really good. So amazing. The actual speed of these, men and women that go on these super fast cycles around Croydon was just astonishing. It just blew me away, literally. And the dedication was very inspiring. And it makes you just want to think, whoa, what am I doing? Literally. I couldn't believe how fast they were taking these corners. It was just unbelievable. And this was like an hour of intense speed and overtaking on these tight corners. And it just made me think, why has no one made a good cycle game like that? Like Tour Series, could there not be someone 2K or someone, or EA, dare I say EA, but maybe 2K Sports would make a really good cycling game, because they're very good at games, are always very detailed. That would be really good. I'd be very much up for playing a game like that, Tour Series, and then they could have Croydon as a stage. Can you imagine Croydon, a stage of Croydon in a video game? Is there anything out there that's ever had Croydon as a video game, stage? I'm sure there's something indie out there, ridiculous. But that would be really good, to have a stage where you could play a cycle game like Tour Series, Pearl Izumi Edition, and you can use your cyclists, train them up and get the stats, and then, ride at full speed around these corners. That would be awesome. Please, somebody, some developer out there, do it, or I'm just going to crowdfund it and try to build it myself. But it will probably look horrible. But anyway, the most I can do is like the voices or something like that. There was this really crazy guy on the on the microphone as well. I don't know if anyone was there, but he was very animated. Here they go for the final lap. I just thought, this guy needs to be in Daytona, USA or something. And he kept doing this thing, like every time there was like a sort of a house or techno track on, he was just like, hop, 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 brrr, hop. He was mad. he's almost as mad as me. But yeah, definitely, I'd love to get that guy in the game. He needs to be in a game. Can just someone employ this guy? I need to find out his name anyway. I'm sure I can find his name on the tourseries.co.uk website or at Pearl Izumi. Maybe I'll ask them, who was the announcer? We need to get him into a game, because he needs to be in a game. He needs to be immortalized, literally, and put in a museum behind a thick glass. Anyway. Oh, gosh, what a nutter. I am, not him. Anyway, let's get into this one now. This is from Totaka Kazumi, and this is from Mitomo, that wonderful app out now on Android and iOS. You need to download it. It's so much fun. If you don't play Nintendo games or you don't even have a console, this is a good way to kind of ease your way back into the gaming world if you've been out of it since Super Mario 2 or Sonic the Hedgehog 1, this will ease you back into games slowly because you can play it on your smartphone. Okay, and it's, you know, it's not a game as such, but it's really good. Download it now. Go onto Android or you know, the Apple Store and type in Miitomo. It's Miitomo. And you can create your own Mii, which is basically a caricature of yourself with a bigger head. And you can dress up your Mii and answer questions. It's a social media app, basically. But you can answer questions from your friends and find out who else is using Miitomo. And your Miis eventually visit each other at their houses. And, you know, you could talk and do all silly things. And it's really fun. And you can also earn money on the game. Not real money, you know, Mii money, Nintendo money. That would be really good if they gave you real money. But, Nintendo are not that generous anyway, but the music is very generous and very good as well. I've played a few from the amazing Kazumi Totaka over the last couple of weeks. He's also the voice of Yoshi. He actually does that voice, this composer, which is there's your fact of the day. This one's really cool. It's called Creating a Mii from the Miitomo soundtrack, out now on Android and Apple Store. Buy it now.
Just about created my Mii now. It's time to start the game. Yes, let's do it.
That's Kazumi Totaka creating a Mii from the Miitomo original soundtrack, out now on Android and Apple Store. Download it now. It's really good. Do it now. Do it now. You have a smartphone. There's no excuse. It's not like I'm telling you to go out and buy a Sega Dreamcast or a Nintendo Wii U or a Sony PlayStation 4. You can do this on your smartphone or your tablet. Do it now. Android, Apple Store, MiTomo, MiTomo. It's good. And I'm not being paid by Nintendo. I promise you. It's just really fun. Seriously. Really cool. Game Video Show, it's 5:32 or 17:32, and it's still 18 Celsius here in Croydon, which is great, because I'm hoping it stays like this so I don't get rained on like last time. The other day I was completely soaked coming in here. It was just pouring down like buckets, but in the middle of June, which is really cool in London. It happens all the time, so don't worry. If you're listening from anywhere else in the world, then I hope you are having glorious weather like most of the world usually has, apart from icy regions, etc. Anyway, yes, have a nice time. It's good. But thank you very much for tuning into the Game Video Show. And if you're staying up late to listen to us, then that's even better. And if you can't listen to us, don't forget, or you missed a show, then you can easily catch up with us, this show and many others, on croydonradio.com. Go to podcasts or, you know, presenters, and you can listen to our last podcast, you know, and or the first podcast we've ever done. It's that good. Such a great system. So seriously, have a listen, share, embed it on your website, and do whatever you have to get the word out there for this show and many others on croydonradio.com. What an advert that was, wasn't it? Anyway, let's get into some more music right now. We've got this one here. It's gorgeous. Gorgeous. It's from the amazing game. It goes by the name of Monster Hunter 3. It's the main theme, or it's called Proof of a Hero. It's by Tetsuya Shibata, and it's just brilliant. I love it. I love this one, and I actually love the other main theme as well, which they have for this game, which is just like, oh my gosh. I played it last week and it just blows you away. Seriously, it really is that good. It can easily be in any Hollywood film, or, you know, any film around the world for that matter. It's just brilliant. But anyway, have a listen to this one. This is Proof of a Hero from the Monster Hunter 3 original soundtrack by Tetsuya Shibata. encore! Amazing! And that's from the wonderful Tetsuya Shibata from the amazing soundtrack that goes by the name of Monster Hunter 3 or Try. And that is the theme called Proof of a Hero. And if there's any proof of a hero, it's in that track, literally. If you need to be a hero, turn that song on. The soundtrack is really good, seriously. I've listened to the other Monster Hunter soundtracks, the more recent one, but this soundtrack just always just, you know, amps me up for whatever I need to do, whether it's the washing up or going outside for a jog. Definitely. It's very good. Very good soundtrack. Well done, Tetsuya Shibata. You can buy Monster Hunter 3 pretty much anywhere, actually. It's on the Wii U. That's where I've played it, but it's on other consoles as well. Developed by Capcom. Was it developed by Capcom or published by Capcom? Probably both, wasn't it? Very good game, though. Very good, very good. Let's get into another one now, and this one is from the Dream Team. It goes by the name of Atsuko Asahi, Atsuka Hayazaki and Hajime Wakai. You might recognize those two names there as well, from the Legend of Zelda soundtracks, Skyward Sword, Twilight Princess, Mario Kart 8. It's like a Nintendo Who's Who. And this one is from this original soundtrack, goes by the name of Pikmin 3. This one's called Garden of Hope, Sunset in brackets. Pikmin 3, wonderful game there. Sort of like an RPG. You take care of these little Pikmin or little aliens and you guide them through the treacherous planet to help them. You know, you have various different Pikmin that can do various different things, like turn into rock and water and this and that. And it's really good. And you're led by the amazing, amazing astronaut spaceman, Olimar. Do you know Olimar? I actually sort of discovered Olimar via Super Smash Brothers as well, which is pretty cool. And he has the Pikmin flying around with him, and is this really fun. Super Smash Brothers is a really, really good game on the Wii U and Nintendo 3DS as well, which I haven't actually played, but I heard it's very good, very good. Ah, amazing. But yes, have a listen to this one here on the Game Video Show with myself, Ivian Caffin. We are here for another 20 minutes approximately. So have a listen to this one. It's called Garden of Hope, Sunset by Atsuka Hayazaki, Atsuko Asahi, Hajime Wakai from the Pikmin 3 soundtrack. Yes. Awesome. That is glorious, Dan. That's Atsuka Hayazaki, Atsuko Asahi, and Hajime Wakai. And that's called The Garden of Hope in Sunset, or in brackets, not in Sunset, in brackets, Sunset from the Pikmin 3 original soundtrack. That is awesome. I like that very much, very much, very much. Really cool to see DJ Steve, who's also on our station as well here on Croydon Radio. First time we've met. I can't believe it. Actually, the first time I've met DJ Steve. That is just surreal. But it was really good to see you, sir, if you're listening to the podcast, obviously, because you've just left the studio. Brilliant, brilliant. Oh, gosh. He was telling me about a game that he might have played that I'm going to try and work out where it's from. It sounded like he was talking about Rayman. He wasn't sure of the name. He's not a massive video game fan, but there was a game that he's played where you go, sort of go down a slope and you're collecting different things. So I'm guessing that sounds like Rayman to me because I'm just insane for video games. So I'm going to find out what the song is, and that is going to be my challenge for the week, is to find out the song which he, you know, he heard and he liked a lot. So let's see how that goes. It's the Game Video Show. We have about 15 minutes to go and there is still more to play. I'm going to try to squeeze in a few more for you before the time ticks down to zero. Zero. Yes, yes, yes. Not long to go, not long to go. But yes, let's get into this one now. This is from my, you know, daily week. Sorry, not daily. I'm not, you know, every day. Am I? Every week. It's the weekly ritual now. This one is from Shenmue 2. And this is by Takenobu Mitsuyoshi. I played something from him earlier doing his singing. Daytona USA when he's in his singing mood, but this one's just an instrumental. And this one is called South Carmine Quarter Night from Shenmue 2. And I like it very much because I just love this game. It's so good. It's seriously so good. Yeah. Yeah. That's from Shenmue 2, the original soundtrack, and composed by Takenobu Mitsuyoshi, and that's called South Carmine Quarter, the night version. Wonderful game. I love that game so much, seriously. There's one part, actually, of the first Shenmue that I just never been able to, you know, really complete properly, and that was possibly the part where you had to the forklift truck. I couldn't do that part. Seriously, it really got on my nerves, but it was really good, and you know what? That every part of that game, you know, teaches you something new. And that part definitely taught you about, you know, repetition and dedication and discipline. And that's what, it, you know, it came down to in that part. And I think it was really a really nice touch to add those sort of, you know, monotonous tasks in a game, and you know, obviously developed by Yu Suzuki. And I think he might play along that he never added that for a reason, but I think that's what he wanted to get across, is that, you know, even though you're hell-bent on revenge, sometimes you just need to do the basic things like, you know, putting the crates into place with your forklift, or, you know, doing the washing up, or, you know, there's always something that needs to be done that will get you to where you need to go, and that's what that game represents for me. You know, monotonous tasks always need to be done, even though, you know, there's no reason why you need to keep collecting all of these rings of Sonic and all of these coins of Mario, but it pays off in the end because you get an extra life, don't you? Or you do a supersonic. So yeah, it does pay off. There's my bit of philosophy for the day, why you play video games, and this is the reason why you should play more video games, basically. It's the Game Video Show. It's 5:48. My name is Ifyan Kaffin. We have a few more tracks to go before we are out of here, but I'm going to play this one quickly because I'm just, you know, Splatoon mad. This is what happens when you win, or when you splattered the whole team, and this is my favorite track because when I win, I hear this. It goes a little bit something like this. Track I love. You like to hear that one when you win on Splatoon. The other one is quite downbeat, isn't it? That's the Game Video Show. My name is Ibie Kafford, and it's completely nuts. That one was composed by Shiho Fuji, Toro Minigishi, and that's the battle win result from the Splatoon original soundtrack, out now on Nintendo Wii U. Wonderful. Where is that from where they say that? When you do a combo and it goes, wonderful. Is that Power Stone? I think so, isn't it? You do like a 4-5 hit combo. Wonderful. Capcom had some of the best announcers for their games, literally. You know, they literally do. I don't know where they get those announcers from, but fair play to Capcom for picking out some of the best guys. Like, what was the other one I played yesterday? I was playing Vampire Chronicles Darkstalkers, and what is it? Round one, fight! He sounds a bit like the Street Fighter guy as well. And then the Street Fighter one is just legendary, isn't it? USSR! Japan! Japan! It's just crazy. All right, let's stop now. It's just, I feel like I'm at home doing all this stuff. Anyway, let's get into some, well, my last couple, actually. It's the last few. Isn't that sad? Let's play this one. It's another Dreamcast classic. It goes by the name of Grandia. Do you remember this one? Yeah. Anyway, if you don't remember it, it was a brilliant RPG developed for the Sega Dreamcast, and it eventually went on to the PlayStation 1 and 2 as well. It was a PlayStation 2, actually. And yeah, it is good. Very good. Very good game. If you like RPGs, and if you don't, then hey, you know, it's a good place to start. It's a good place to start, definitely. It's wonderful. Wonderful! And it's by Noriyuki Iwadari. Noriyuki Iwadari. Ah, that's nice. Nice name. And this is the theme of Grandia, and it's from the Grandia original soundtrack, and it's wonderful. Thank you.
that sound so much like an 80s American series, doesn't it? With those trumpet and trombone there. It just reminds me of, I don't know, Dallas or something.
And this week on Dallas, Sally finds out who stole her loaf of bread. Jimmy finds out why his car isn't working. This week on Dallas.
It just reminds me of that, doesn't it? It's that terrible voice. Anyway, that's wonderful.
Wonderful!
And that's Noriyuki Iwadare. And that's the theme of Grandia on the Sega Dreamcast. That's where I played it anyway. From the Grandia game.
Wonderful.
PlayStation 2 as well. Wonderful. God, I think he said that.
Wonderful!
Capcom, you and your crazy announcers. Anyway, talking of crazy, this is the last song from me. Well, not from me, personally, but from the Game Video Show today. And this one is great. It is Michiru Oshima and Koichi Yamazaki. And it's You Were There from the Ico soundtrack. From the Sony PlayStation 2 originally, and then the Sony PlayStation 3. Very good, and it's very wonderful as well. Very nice, I like this. We will be back same time next week from the same time. I just said the same time, didn't I? The same time next week from the same time. 1600 hours every Thursday or 4 p.m. in normal speak. Be there or be square. Yes, you'll enjoy it again. We'll have more goodies next week and more music. And if you missed this show in its entirety, don't forget you can listen again using the podcast selection tool on the CroydonRadio.com website. The podcast selection tool. Anyway, yeah, you can listen again. Very simple. Follow me online as well. It's Game Video Show on Facebook and also Game Video Show 1 on Twitter, or Ivian Caffin. And don't forget to follow at Croydon Radio on Twitter as well, and keep up to date with the latest going ons in your favourite town in the UK. And if you live abroad, don't worry. There's plenty of good music to entertain you. Anyway, I am out of here. Enjoy the rest of your day or night or wherever you are, and have a fantastic week. And I shall see you or hear from you same time next week, live on the Game Video Show.